Hey everyone, welcome to the SimpleLink Connect series. My name is Nick Smith. We're actually missing Adrian today, but that's okay because we have a great guest. I have Kevin Kessler with me. He's a product marketing engineer on our 2.4 gigahertz team, and he's going to take us through how to get started on some of our newest devices. Thanks for joining us, Kevin.
Hi, glad to be here, Nick.
Awesome. All right. So I know you're going to kind of take us through the first example you want to run on our devices. So can you tell me a little bit about this example? What is the out-of-box or the very first example?
Sure. So today I'm going to be talking about the out-of-box demo for Project Zero, which is the first example in the SimpleLink Academy. Specifically today, I'll be talking about the Project Zero for Bluetooth Low Energy 5. And this uses the SimpleLink Academy to go through each step and guides you along so you can download the project, learn it, and start developing today. And it's great whether you're a seasoned developer or just getting started. It's a great first example to learn the ropes there.
Perfect. So it takes you from right when you get the new devices and development kits to up and running. And for those of you who are repeat viewers, you may have seen that we have a session on SimpleLink Academy, a Connect series video. If you haven't seen that one, definitely check it out. And with that, Kevin, how about you, let's just get into it. Take us through the example and show us how to get up and running.
Sure. So Project Zero is connecting a LaunchPad to your phone, where the phone will be a central Bluetooth low energy device and we'll be able to control the launch pads and change some of the LEDs and even change some small parts of the application. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So first, you'll need a launch pad. I'll be using the CC26X2R1 launch pad. And then also you'll need to download CCS, which is the Code Composer Studio. So what I'm showing on my screen right now is the Code Composer Studio, where we can open up the TI Resource Explorer and start at Project Zero. So the first project is where we will download the SimpleLink SDK and import the Bluetooth Low Energy 5 stack for the CC26X2R1 launchpad, or whichever launchpad you'll be using. Next, we'll go ahead and connect the launchpad to the computer and we can go ahead and start debugging the project. So now that the project is imported from Resource Explorer, we will right click here and debug as Code Composer Debug Session. So now we are debugging and flashing our first example out of the box straight onto the launch pad. And once that's flashed to the device, we can start connecting it to our phone using the SimpleLink Starter app. Okay, so as you see, it loads pretty quickly. And we can go ahead and pull up the app. So now what I'm showing is the SimpleLink Starter app. This app should begin scanning for Bluetooth Low Energy devices automatically, but if it doesn't, you can refresh the list by pulling down. So as you see here, we have the Project Zero in the list, and you can click on it and click Sensor View and use the GUI to interact with different services. So I'm gonna be showing the LED service, and we can see here that if I press this button, it will turn on and off the LaunchPad LEDs from the phone. So within a couple of minutes, I was able to download a project, an out-of-box example, connect it to downloading it to the LaunchPad and connect to the phone and start playing around with it. So it's pretty quick.
Yeah, that's very cool. Thanks for showing us, Kevin. It's amazing that, you know, you have the kit and you're communicating with the phone, you know, within a matter of a minute or a couple of minutes. Now I know TI Connectivity announced the release of all the new 13XX and 26XX products, in addition to the ones that are already out there today. And some of those products support other protocols in addition to Bluetooth Low Energy, such as Zigbee, Thread, and different sub 1 gigahertz protocols. So is there a similar Project Zero, or how do you interact with the other protocols and examples?
Yeah, great question. So what I showed was just one project example. So Project Zero is the first one in the Bluetooth Low Energy 5 stack, but we also have Zigbee, Thread, and other proprietary 15.4 stacks where you can have Project Zeros in those respective stacks. In addition to that, the software is API compatible, so it'll all look the same. So you can quickly switch in between protocols with ease.
Got it. Thanks. Yeah. So it sounds like with all these new products released that scale, you know, up in memory, they scale different features. We actually do have another video talking more about that. All of these products, you can have a similar out-of-box Project Zero experience to kickstart your development. And then as you move forward, all of the software remains compatible as you move across these different protocols. So that's very cool. Now, in addition to all this software compatibility, you mentioned different launch pads, different devices. What does the hardware compatibility look like?
Yeah, really good question. So, for instance, I use the CC26X2R1 launch pad, and I use it for the Project Zero, which is a simple application. But say I wanted to do a more complex application or use a lower memory device, we have several devices releasing this year with different memory footprints, so you can quickly switch out the hardware devices, and they're all pin-to-pin compatible. So we have the CC13X1 devices, the CC13X2 devices, as well as the CC26X1 devices and the CC26X2 devices.
Okay. Yeah, very cool. Well, Kevin, thank you so much for joining us and showing that example, how easy it is to get up and running with all of these new products, and how we maintain the compatibility and similarity of the training environments and the software and hardware as you move through these products. If you're interested in getting started with any of these examples or looking at the new products, you can get started at ti.com/SimpleLink. Thanks everybody for joining. As always, we have very cool topics coming up, so be sure to stay tuned. There's more to come. Thank you.